please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Sudarshan, good morning to you. Is there an index trade at all, or would you again say that we avoid for the moment?
Good morning. No, we are locked in a narrow trading range, and that trading range is going to move, break. It's a matter of time. I think it's a matter of days. We've lasted 3 weeks, and 3 weeks is more than enough. So our research tells us that the breakout or the breakdown is imminent. So there is an index trade. 10,700 is taken out. We won't even wait for a closing level. We'll probably start buying puts, and you should go short. Use July expiry options. If in the unlikely event that 10,830 is taken out on the upside, I think there is probably another 100 or 150 points of up move left there, and then we should be long. It's difficult to make a call, but I would assume that it's easier and probably more likely that we'll break on the downside. But we could easily do either of the two. So wait patiently for a break of the edges and then take that trade. Inside the edges, I would only be a buyer, because this market is buying willingly rewarding people who are buying on dips. So above 700, 10,700, buy on any intraday dip for 10, 20, 30 points, whatever you can get or not get. But beyond these two levels, 10,700 and 10,830, take aggressive positions.
Okay, well, everyone's been going on holiday, but someone who's been patiently swimming through these calm waters is Prakash Gaba. Prakash, you've seen this range play out for a while now. You think it's going to be a while before we break out either way? And what's the trade on the index today?
In fact, it's contracted a lot. Good morning, Sonia. And I feel that maybe we are on the verge of an expanded day. May not have happened a breakout, but the ranges are clearly defined. On the downside, we have around 10,590, 600 zones, very deep. But close to that is around 10,700 on the lower side. Upside around 10,830 to 900 zones. So it depends where we open. If we open the upper regions, very good chance we could see a big down day. If it opens the lower regions, good chance we can see an up more. The problem is when it opens where it is closed yesterday. That's a big issue. So maybe we'll have to play it for a while, half an hour, 1 hour, and then see which side it expands and then chase that. So far, we'll have to be very stock specific. I don't think there's much trade on the Nifty if it opens straight. We'll have to wait for a while.
Okay, that's interesting. Ashwani, all buys for you. That's quite interesting. And across various sectors.
See, the market is doing nothing, so there's nothing you can do based on the index. And the problem is that it's an overall environment. This is not an expanding environment. Even if we do kind of break out on either side, chances are we'll fall back into the range. So that is the sort of view I have. For the moment, Bata is hitting fresh highs. I am sticking to 52-week high stocks, because if you remain in those 15, you tend to do well. So that's a buy with a stop of 838, target of 870. TCS is a buy with a stop of 1830, target of 1895. Hexaware is a buy with a stop of 455, target of 480. And cement, I've been saying this for several days, that this is looking like a bottom. Not because I have some great fundamental information, but it's hitting the lows that it's hit in the past several years where it's made a bottom. So commodity stocks often, the stocks bottom out before the sector does. So it appears that the sector is bottoming out because it's hit lows which it's done since 2013. So Ultratech is a buy with a stop of 3800, target of 3960. Ambuja Cement is a buy with a stop of 207, target of 223.